This has got it a long way away. So he just goes to the toe poke. Snook goes to short pass. Excellent kick. Floats marks. He's too far out. Oh, no, he's not.
Up Tringo paddling. Nicholson's right there with him on hands and knees. Marlon Moth up close. Back to Agnew. They're in attack again. The base.
Well, they got the two of them to push forward. Something he can do. He's very highly skilled for a big man.
Throw in Tringove, actually, because the ball didn't get too far, but he was quick enough to take it, Gregson.
A player in Brisbane Lion. Little scoop by Partington. The umpire said that's okay to Snook. And running with the flight is McCarthy, and he takes the mark in front of Mays.
As to which way it's going, because there are a few that got pretty excited. But not to be. Not to be. Kick back into the middle of the Adelaide Oval. Snook over the top. Does well. Got the ball knocked on towards his teammate in Nicholson. In towards Close. Close does well. Kicked by Gregson! Partington, I should say.
Ten up, so as many of these as they have will really suit Glenelg.
Yeah, it certainly will, Michael.
Hayes knocks it down for Port Adelaide. Now emerging is Snook. Snook's kick out in front of McBean. McBean and Corcoran. Oh, McBean just pushes off. And now a little chip kick. Overcooked it. Here's Scott. He's got to dodge around. Threw it on the boot. It's a
West Adelaide.
West Adelaide as well. Up they fly. No one can take it. Frederick was front and square. Couldn't quite release the ball. And Matty Snook is there just riding him like a bucking bronco. Andrew Bradley's been important for them back in the centre. Could we have another Collingwood resurgence against GWS from last night? Who knows? Port will need to get a wriggle on if that's the case.